Now let's see about swing component J table class. J table is mainly useful in order to display information in the form of rows and columns. Let's see the constructors of the J table class. J table left parenthesis, right parenthesis. It creates an empty table. Second constructor, J table of object. This is nothing but first dimension, rows. Here we have two dimensions. Rows. So rows are specified with the help of two dimensions. Next object, calls are specified with the help of one dimension. So it will create a table with the specified rows and calls data. Rows are specified with the help of two dimensions. So rows is nothing but it is a two dimensional array, whereas calls is nothing but a one dimensional array. We will see that in the example. Next one, methods of JTable class. First one, get row count. It will returns the total number of rows which are present in the table. Get columns. It will returns the total number of columns present in the table. But here there is a difference. Get column count is not the method name. Name of the method is get columns. Next, add column. It will returns. It will adds a column to the end of the table. So if you want to add an extra column to the end of the table, then we have to go for add column method. Next, let's see the program. Import space java x dot swing dot star semicolon. X stands for extension, java extension. So this is the parent package. This parent package contains a sub package called swing. Swing package contains several classes like jframe, jtable and component. Component class contains several methods like setBounds method, add method, setSize method, setVisible method, setLayout method. Next, tableDemo is nothing but name of the class. This is nothing but constructor. We know that constructor name must be same as the class name. Next, we have created an object for the jframe. jframe f is equal to new jframe. So this is nothing but our frame. Next we have created rows. So for rows, we have taken a two-dimensional array. So string is nothing but a data type. So it contains all the values as strings. Data is nothing but name of the array. It is a two-dimensional array. So we have two subscripts, where the first subscript specifies row size, second subscript specifies column size. Here we have four one-dimensional arrays. This is the first one-dimensional array, second one-dimensional array, third one-dimensional array, fourth one-dimensional array. First one-dimensional array values 1 Ramesh 40,000. So within the curly braces we have placed the values, comma, second one dimensional array values, within the curly braces values, next comma symbol, comma, next third one dimensional values, comma, next fourth one dimensional array values, within the curly braces, within the double quotation 4 comma, within the double quotation Suresh comma, within the double quotation 70,000. So this is nothing but closing of the fourth one dimensional array. Closing of this right curly brace ends with the semicolon. Okay, so this is nothing but rows. Next, string column. So it is a one dimensional array. So one left square bracket, one right square bracket. One subscript is enough here. Where here, what is the first heading here? ID. Next, name. Next, salary. Next, we have to create the J table. Here we are using the second constructor, J table of J table t is equal to new J table of, here it accepts two values. The first values is row. Here rows are specified with the help of string name data comma. Next, columns are specified with the help of a variable called column. Okay. Once a table is created, then we have to specify the boundary. So where we need to add the table. So that should be done with the help of setBounds method. So t dot setBounds of, so this 30 specifies x coordinate, 40 specifies y coordinate, this 100 specifies width, this 100 specifies width, whereas this 150 specifies height. Okay. Next, once the control is created, we have to add that control to the frame. So f dot add of t, so that our table will be added to the frame. So what is our table? So this is nothing but column. So what are the column headings? ID, name, salary. ID, name, salary are nothing but column headings. Whereas what is the first row value? 1 Ramesh 40,000. 1 Ramesh 40,000. Second row, 2 Mahesh 50,000. to Mahesh 50,000. Likewise, the remaining rows will also get displayed. Next one, f dot set size of 400 500. So 400 is nothing but width, 500 is nothing but height. Next one, f dot set visible of 2. Okay, so initially the frame will be in invisible state, so we have to make that frame as visible. That should be done with the help of set visible method. In this program, there is no need to use f dot set layout manager. Generally, we use f dot set layout of null statement in every frame program. But in this program, we are displaying data in the form of rows and columns. So when we are displaying data in the form of rows and columns, that means we are maintaining some layout here. Okay, so we have layouts like flow layout, border layout. This is nothing but grid layout. Grid layout means displaying information in the form of rows and columns. So we are using one layout manager. So that's why there is no need to use of that statement. F dot set layout of null is not necessary here. Why? Because by default, JTable will use grid layout manager. Next, right calibres. This is nothing but end of the constructor. Next, public static void main string args. We know that execution of the program starts from the main method. From the main method, we have to call the constructor. We can call the constructor automatically by creating the object. So we know how to create the object, new table demo. So whenever the statement is executed, an object is created for table demo class, as well as this constructor will be called. Here there is no need to create any reference variable like table demo obj is equal to new table demo. The table demo obj, that statement is not needed. Why? Because in this program there is no need of any object towards. So that's why only object is created. So whenever an object is created, then the constructor will be called. So all the statements in the program will be executed. So this is nothing but the end of the corresponding class. So next we have to compile the program, execute the program. So how to execute the program? Java space table demo dot java. So whenever we execute the program, then we will get an output like this. So this is about JTable class in Sphinx.